Welcome back. I'm Shane. This is Relative Time. And today we're going to talk about one of the most intriguing Kickstarter watches of 2022. It's also going to be the most mispronounced watch of the year. We're talking about the Biotic Formicidae. And I'm not even sure that's the proper way to say it. The quickest way to describe this one is to first imagine a Seiko Alpinist, and then imagine someone doing a complete reimagining of it with a retro sci-fi theming. Basically, just Flash Gordon the hell out of it. And in the end, you wind up with this. The Biotic shares the same internal compass bezel as the Alpinist, and in the same way, it's sort of done in the same spirit of that watch. But other than that compass, nothing else looks quite the same. In fact, the Formicidae looks completely different than anything else I've ever seen. Now, before we jump into this one, do be aware that this is a prototype that I'm looking at, and as such, all your standard prototype warnings apply. I already know of a couple changes, and we'll talk about those as we go on. And as far as I know, the Kickstarter will be launching sometime next month in June. That said, let's move on to the specs. For this one, you're looking at a modest 39mm sized watch with a lug to lug of 46.7. It's also reasonably thin for a watch with 200 meters of water resistance at 11.7mm. And that's 11.7 from the sorta exhibition case back, which we'll talk more about later, all the way to the top of the flat sapphire crystal with AR. So, relatively speaking, it's a modest platform. Yet, there's nothing really modest about this watch, especially on your wrist. There's nothing here, either visually or physically, that feels compact. From a design perspective, Biotic did a fantastic job here. And those dual crowns on the opposite sides of the watch are really key to the design. They definitely give the watch a unique profile, and they clearly help it stand out from other watches with internal bezels. But while they look good, those crowns don't help at all when it comes to ergonomics. Which leads us to the first of two issues I have with the Formicidae, and this one is easily the biggest of the two. On the wrist, those prominent crowns stick out. A lot. Which not only makes the watch feel a little larger, but they will occasionally hit the back of your hand. Plus, due to the size and positioning, you can't really use either of those crowns when it's on your wrist. So if you actually want to adjust the time or set the bezel, this is one you're gonna have to take off. Now, as bad as that sounds, it's not something I would actually call a deal killer, because you don't actually feel those crowns that often, it's just on occasion. And as a whole, I'd say the watch is fairly comfortable to wear throughout the day, a lot of which is thanks to its great bracelet. It's pretty well balanced, particularly on that bracelet, as well as it's just an amazing and honestly mesmerizing watch to look at. In some ways, I think they might have been better served if they did a more conventional crown setup, like, say, on the Alpinist. But at the same time, it wouldn't quite be the same watch, and it wouldn't be as unique to look at. So it all just boils down to a form versus function situation, and in this particular instance, form one. And in some ways, it's also a similar theme with a few of the other issues here. For some, this is going to be a huge negative. And especially on a watch that is essentially supposed to be a tool watch. But for others, well, just keep watching, because Biotic really pushed the design element to create something truly interesting. With the case design being an integral part of that, it's entirely brushed, and in that way it maintains a slight tool watchy kind of vibe. Yet, at the same time, it's very elaborate and visually interesting to look at. You have curvy sidewalls, short organically flowing lugs, and a very slim, clean bezel. And all of that gives the Formicidae a very sleek and modern profile. When you think about it, it's actually quite an accomplishment that Biotic was able to create something so eye-catching that isn't all polished and flashy. And personally, I really love the indentations on the side, and this reminds me a lot of that recent Timex S1. It's really an interesting watch to look at, as it's very sci-fi-ish or maybe even Escher-ish. From this angle, the only negative thing I can really say about it is that despite the AR on the crystal, there is still quite a bit of reflection. So perhaps they can add some more AR layers before this thing goes into full production. We've also already talked about the negative issues of the larger, more prominent crowns. But there is a positive side to those as well, which is that they're very easy to unscrew and use, at least assuming it's not on your wrist. They're also signed with two different designs, and that does help you remember which one is for setting the time and which crown is for the internal bezel. And just for reference, Biotic has mentioned that they're planning to change the shape and size just slightly of those crowns. Until I actually see them in person, I can't really tell you how it's going to change it, but that is something to bear in mind. When it comes to design, it's always a very tricky and subjective issue, but I personally really love what Biotic has done here. It's interesting and unique, with a remarkable sense of refinement and cohesion that continues throughout the entire thing, including underneath the crystal. But before we really get to the dial, we do need to talk about my other issue. And the reason I'm stressing about how refined I think the design is because when you turn the watch around, it's a completely other story. This really doesn't seem to match what's going on in the front. Now, I'd be lying if I said I hated this. The kid in me or the gamer geek in me actually likes it. It's kind of like something out of Fallout meets Deadpool. But the other side of me, the one who at least tries to be normal in public, thinks this is a huge mistake. I'm sure there's some logic to this design. After all, the name Formicidae does refer to the family of ants. And the watch itself is said to be a mechanical watch inspired by Earth's little navigators. But regardless of that, I don't think the cartoony case spec really matches the same level of detail and refinement that you find on the front. If they did this design without color as just an embossed closed case spec, I think it could work. But as it is, no. Anyway, let's move on to what is one of the most interesting dials I've ever seen. Now, there's a lot to unpack here, so let's just start at the middle and work our way out. At the very center, we have this curved dial, with this particular version being this bold sunburst bronzish color. It's very striking, and it does remind me of kind of the coloring you see in a cat's eye stone. But if this is not your cup of tea, I believe there will be three other colorways. The dial itself is partially curved. The very main area, the biggest part of it, is completely flat, and it only seems to curve down at its outer edges, right before you meet a detailed chapter ring. In kind of an interesting twist, there aren't any separate applied indices with this design. Rather, the hour markers are on the chapter ring, in a thicker off-yellow luminous paint, with the cardinal points in particular actually pushing into cutouts that are made into the main dial. And these hour markers are one aspect I really love. It helps it stand out, and it just brings those two elements together, as well as it creates a very obvious and very effective crosshair effect, orientating the watch as you wear it and really helping you focus in on the hands. Then, just beyond that, you have the inner compass bezel, which has been elevated to a flat platform that sits above the rest of the dial, physically separating it from the timekeeping elements, yet still keeping it very integrated with the overall design. Back to the center, you have the branding on that inner flat section of the dial, which overall I like the font size and the symmetric balance, but I'm not quite sold on the two different styles of font. They just seem to clash against each other. Then moving down to the 6, you also have a cutout for the date, which in general I think looks rather cool as it's integrated into the curved section of the dial. Yet since that date wheel is actually recessed down on kind of a lower level and a more shadow covered level, it makes it really hard to read at times. Which then leads us to the hands to talk about. Now, the hands are a set of simple flat swords with an off-yellow or old radium luminous paint in the center. The brushed finish of the hands looks a little bit off against the sunburst center, but I think it does help them stand out nicely. In some ways, the hour hand might be a little short, but I think when you take the design in its entirety, it actually looks perfect here, as the hand stays just in that center flat section of the dial, whereas the other two hands extend out far into the chapter ring and almost into the compass bezel. One of the other proposed changes that I know about is that the minute hand is going to be a little bit shorter. And as long as they don't shorten it too much, I think the handset overall will have a nice balance to it. Biotic did a great job creating a number of interesting components, making a dial with numerous layers and textures, resulting in a fantastic level of depth, and just a generally fascinating watch to look at. And one thing I really appreciate is just how complex the design is, yet it all seems to flow together nicely at the same time, which also includes the case and bracelet. Combine all of that together, and I think you get one of the more interesting and unique field watches I've ever run into. Although it's not perfect, and I think it needs to be said that while the watch is great to look at, and everything comes through clearly with a great level of contrast, if you do compare this to, say, a traditional field watch, it is going to be harder to read. And once again, you wind up with another form versus function argument. With regard to Lume, the design here, The Lume profile, if you will, is simply brilliant. With the cardinal points of the compass in green to match the extended indices, and then a small amount of blue BGW9 mixed in. It's also worth noting that Biotic plans to Lume the date wheel as well, and that'll certainly take the cool factor up a notch. But if you haven't noticed already, there is a problem here. That green Lume comes from an old radium style, or as I like to call it, fadium style Lume. And I call it that because it does exactly that. Honestly, I'm starting to get frustrated with this, because over the last year, it seems like every other week I'm talking about fadium. Because for whatever reason, fadium has become a big trendy thing to use. And while I fully get why some brands want to use it with their designs, I just really wish they wouldn't, as it just doesn't have the staying power of BGW9 or C3. And that's something you can clearly see in this comparison test. So if you want to use fadium, you either have to use a ton of it, or just use something else, which is what I prefer. Now, the Formicidae is a field watch, and that begs the obvious question of if it actually needs better Lume. Probably not, but I'd still prefer it if it did. And hopefully they can actually improve the Lume before final production, just because a watch at this price really should last longer than a cheap Vostok. So let's move on to the bracelet, and in short, the bracelet is pretty great. The bracelet has solid links secured with screws, a milled push button clasp with a diver's extension, as well as solid end links that have quick release pins. There's also a very minor taper going from 20 to 18 at the clasp. Just like the case, the bracelet is mostly brushed, and I really like how the linear brushing on the lugs seems to perfectly match up with that of the bracelet, giving the whole thing a seamless transition. Moving down the bracelet, you soon run into a very interesting design element, and that's that the center sections of the bracelet are bead blasted rather than brushed. Just like the watch, the brushed nature gives the watch still a tool watchy vibe. Yet the contrast between the brushed and blasted sections makes it very interesting and eye-catching without being polished and flashy. And in that regard, it perfectly matches the watch head to create a truly unique and intriguing piece. Overall, it's a great bracelet and fairly comfortable. The only real negative thing I have to say about it is that the diver's extension clasp looks a bit chunky, which is kind of at odds from the otherwise sleek and curvy profile of the watch. So perhaps a less chunky and more traditional clasp would have worked better. As for the movement, Biotic is going with Miyota 9015. For the price range they're going for, I think it's a perfect choice. Now that I think about it, we've been seeing a lot of 9015s lately, so I kind of feel like a broken record here for saying this. But once again, the 9015 is a nice upgrade over your standard Seiko movements. Yet at the same time, it comes in at a better price than your Swiss alternatives. So right at this sort of mid-tier price point, I think it's a great option. And speaking of price, the Biotic will be launching with a Kickstarter early bird price of $399. These days, getting a watch with a Miyota 9000 series movement for around $400 seems to be pretty fair. And here with the Formicidae, you're getting one with a fairly striking and unique design. So overall, I think the price is good. The only thing that should give you a little bit of a pause is to remember that this is a Kickstarter and this is a new brand on Kickstarter. In my experiences, Kickstarters usually seem to work out fine, but you should always remember that there is a little bit of a risk. In these days, there always seems to be some minor hiccups when it comes to the production timeline, of which established brands always seem to know how to navigate those complications easier. So just something to think about. Now, it goes without saying that design is always subjective. And if you're someone that, say, loves the Alpinist, and you're someone that loves the Alpinist for its classic look, then this watch, the Formicidae with its retro sci-fi or maybe Buck Roger-fied look, may just be too odd or too chaotic for you. It might be as confusing as the name. Personally, I'm a fan of these kinds of field watches. I'm also a fan of very unique designs. And this is just a great pairing of the two, which is the same reason I love the Akura Wayfarer. So it's not really surprising that I like this one as well. I just wish I could pronounce it better. Now, the Formicidae is far from a perfect watch, and there are a number of things that I hope get changed before final production. As it is, it's a good watch, but there are just a few minor things that are keeping it from being great. Plus, there's a very solid argument here that they pushed form over function too many times on what is essentially supposed to be a tool watch. And I could even see an argument that this really isn't a field watch. That maybe it should be classified as a sports, But despite all of that, I think the positives here far outweigh the negatives. And regardless of what you want to classify this thing as, I think most would agree that Biotic did a fantastic job of designing and creating something very interesting and very unique. Which is why I think this is going to be one of the most intriguing Kickstarter watches of the year, and I'm personally eager to see what happens with it. But in the meantime, let me know your thoughts on this watch from Biotic down below, as well as if you found any other interesting field watches you think I should take a look at. And as always, if you enjoyed the video, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. I'm Shane, this is Relative Time, see you next time.